Advice is a combination of a memoir, a collection of stories that I wrote as a reporter in Japan. It is not fiction, it is nonfiction. I'm an investigative journalist. I don't write about investigative journalists, I just write about the things that I do and the people that I met. Sometimes I may change their names so they don't go to jail or so they don't spend the rest of their life in shame because they've done awful things that they don't want their family to know about. So Tokyo Vice is the first book I've written, and next year I'll have two books finally coming out after quite a long time. So it is the story of my time in Japan and about 16 years of covering Japanese organized crime, run-of-the-day Japanese serial killers, fraud, and everything. As you can see, I'm obviously not Japanese. I am from Columbia, Missouri, a very liberal town in the middle of the Bible Belt, what we used to call it the liberal black hole in the middle of Missouri, where everybody has a gun. And it's one of the few states where almost anyone can get a permit to carry a concealed weapon. Since everybody's carrying guns, we are all very polite to each other, showing that gun control actually does work. The problem is not too many guns, just not enough guns. And Japan has absolutely no guns. Last year, I think there was one shooting death, and the person killed was a Yakuza boss, so it's not even like a human being died. So it's not really an issue in that country. When I was in high school, I was picked on by members of the soccer team, mostly because I was kind of a wise ass, not the calm, polite person I am today. And one day I realized that the only way to cope with the person picking on me and bothering me was to beat up one of them. And so I waited until biology class, and let's just call him Jock. As he was leaving, I kicked him in the balls, and then I grabbed his head and smashed it on the table. Now, this was a calculated risk because he was such a disruptive influence in the class that I could tell that the teacher didn't like him very much. So the teacher called us both up to the head of the class, and he said, Jake, can you tell me what happened here? And he said, there's two scenarios that I can see. One is that, Jock, you tripped and you hurt your nose and you need to go to the nurse's office. Or the other one is that this skinny little Jewish boy just beat you up and he needs to be expelled and you'll still need to go to the nurse's office. Which is it? And he said, I tripped. So he left. I was overjoyed. And then the teacher said to me, not so fast, Mr. Edelstein. You have anger issues and you can't go around beating up people to solve your problems. So I really should expel you, but because he is such a problem in this class, I'm going to let it go if you enroll in karate school. So I entered karate, and in karate class, I learned from my teacher who'd grown up in Okinawa about Japanese culture, about Zen Buddhism, about harnessing your energy, learning to endure. The Japanese are very much into silent endurance of horrible things. I think that's a virtue in Japanese society. And upon reading some Japanese literature and more about it, I decided I would go to Japan and study. When I went to Japan as an exchange student, I was very lucky that I quickly found a place to live that was not a home for foreigners, but was a Zen Buddhist temple. And I spent most of my college life living in the Zen Buddhist temple. And as I was debating three choices, go to work for Sony, become a Buddhist priest, or take the examinations to become a newspaper journalist. So I took the job at the newspaper, and the very first thing that you get when you're on a newspaper in Japan is they put you on the police beat. It doesn't matter where you are. It doesn't matter whether you're fluent in Chinese or French. As a matter of fact, one of the people who joined me on the police beat, we all called him Frenchie, very, very good French, pretty good English. But like me and everyone else who was hired that year, he had to start on the police beat. And in a sense, maybe I was lucky because the police aren't very friendly to new reporters, and they were the meanest to him rather than me. Because he spoke French and he was very educated, the police didn't like him very much. And for me, because I was a barbarian and obviously not Japanese, they cut me a lot more slack. By year two, I was covering the organized crime task force, theft, and public security. And the thing about Japan is, and I'll make this really brief, is there's not a lot of crime in Japan. But there's just enough crime that if you're covering it, there's always something to do. So it is a very, very busy lifestyle. And in the time that I was there, I covered one case of a serial murderer, which was a husband and wife that probably killed 10 people, carved up the bodies. They probably fed them to the dogs that they were selling at the pet shop. We never wrote that in the paper because it would have been disrespectful, and we don't really know. We suspect. And his fatal mistake was actually killing a Yakuza boss. That was the first introduction I had to the Yakuza, really, was working on this story about a serial killer that had probably killed 10 people, one of them being a Yakuza boss, and trying to figure out why the Yakuza boss had been killed and what he did for a living and who his mistress was and what he was doing on his last days on Earth and which detectives had been assigned to the homicide squad to investigate this case. So I don't want to give away too much of the book, but as you read it, you'll find out what are the relationships between the police and the reporters in Japan. What are the relationships between the Yakuza and the police? What are the relationships between Yakuza, police, and reporter when they're all talking to each other on the same subject? And in many aspects, what are the ways that Japanese society works?